The 18th year, the 22nd day of the first month, there was talk in the house of Nebuchadnezzar, king of the Assyrians, that he should, as he said, avenge himself on all the earth. And Nebuchadnezzar called Holofernes, the chief captain of his army, and said unto him, Thus saith the great king, the Lord of the whole earth, Behold, thou shalt go forth from my presence, and take with thee men that trust in their own strength, of footmen 120,000, and the number of horses with their riders 12,000. And thou shalt go against all the west country, because they disobeyed my commandment. I will go forth in my wrath against them, and I will cover the whole face of the earth with the feet of mine army. And I will give them for a spoil unto them, so that their slain shall fill their valleys and brooks, and the river shall be filled with their dead, till it overflow. And I will lead them captives to the utmost parts of all the earth. Then Holofernes went forth from the presence of his lord, and called all the governors and captains, and the officers of the army of Asia. And he mustered the chosen men for the battle, as his lord had commanded him, unto 120,000, and 12,000 archers on horseback. Then he went forth in all his power to cover all the face of the earth westward with their chariots and horsemen and their chosen footmen. A great number also of sundry countries came with them, like locusts and like the sand of the earth, for the multitude was without number. Then he went over Euphrates and went through Mesopotamia and destroyed all the high cities that were upon the river Arbonai till he come to the sea. And he took the borders of Cilicia and killed all that resisted him. Then he went down into the plain of Damascus in the time of wheat harvest, and burnt up all their fields, and destroyed their flocks and herds. Also he spoiled their cities, and utterly wasted their countries, and smote all their young men with the edge of the sword. Now the children of Israel that dwelt in Judea heard all that Holofernes had done to the nations, and after what manner he had spoiled all their temples and brought them to naught. Therefore they were exceedingly afraid of him, and were troubled for Jerusalem and for the temple of the Lord their God, for they were newly returned from the captivity. Therefore they possessed themselves beforehand of all the tops of the high mountains and fortified the villages that were in them and laid up victuals for the provision of war. Then came unto Holofernes all the chief of the children of Esau and all the governors of the people of Moab and the captains of the seacoast and said, Let our Lord now hear a word, that there be not an overthrow in thine army. For the people of the children of Israel do not trust in their spears, but in the height of the mountains wherein they dwell, because it is not easy to come up to the tops of their mountains. Now therefore, my lord, fight not against them in battle array, and there shall not so much as one man of thy people perish. Remain in thy camp, and keep all the men of thine army, and let thy servants get into their hands the fountain of water, which issueth forth at the foot of the mountain. For all the inhabitants of Bethulia have their water thence, so shall thirst kill them. And they shall give up their city, and we and our people shall go up to the tops of the mountains that are near, and will camp upon them, to watch that none go out of the city. So they and their wives and their children shall be consumed with famine, and before the sword come against them, they shall be overthrown in the streets where they dwell. Thus shalt thou render them an evil reward, because they rebelled and met not thy person peaceably. And these words pleased Holofernes, and he appointed to do as they had spoken. So the camp of the children of Ammon departed, and with them 5,000 of the Assyrians, and they pitched in the valley, and took the waters and the fountains of the waters of the children of Israel. Then the children of Israel cried unto the Lord their God, because their heart failed, for all their enemies had compassed them round about, and there was no way to escape out from among them. And the cisterns were emptied, and they had not water to drink their fill for one day, for they gave them drink by measure. Therefore their young children were out of heart, and their women and young men fainted for thirst, and fell down in the streets of the city, and by the passages of the gates, and there was no longer any strength in them. Then all the people assembled to Ozias, and to the chief of the city, both young men and women and children, and cried with a loud voice, and said before all the elders, God be judge between us and you, for ye have done us great injury, in that ye have not required peace of the children of Azel. For now we have no helper, but God hath sold us into their hands, that we should be thrown down before them with thirst and great destruction. Now therefore, call them unto you, and deliver the whole city for a spoil to the people of Holofernes and to all his army. For it is better for us to be made a spoil unto them than to die for thirst. For we will be his servants, that our souls may live, and not see the death of our infants before our eyes, nor our wives, nor our children to die. Then there was great weeping with one consent in the midst of the assembly, and they cried unto the Lord God with a loud voice. Then said Ozias to them, Brethren, be of good courage. Let us yet endure 5 days, in the which space the Lord our God may turn his mercy toward us, for he will not forsake us utterly. And if these days pass, and there come no help unto us, I will do according to your word. Now at that time Judith heard thereof, which was the daughter of Merari, and Manasseh was her husband, of her tribe and kindred, who died in the barley harvest. For as he stood overseeing them that bound sheaves in the field, the heat came upon his head, and he fell on his bed, and he died in the city of Bethulia, and they buried him with his fathers in the field. So Judith was a widow in her house 3 years and 4 months, and she made her a tent upon the top of her house, and put on sackcloth upon her loins, and wore her widow's apparel. And she fasted all the days of her widowhood, save the eves of the Sabbaths and the Sabbaths, and the eves of the new moons and the new moons. She was also of a goodly countenance, and very beautiful to behold. And her husband Manasseh had left her gold and silver and men servants and maid servants and cattle and lands, and she remained upon them. And there was none that gave her an ill word, for she feared God greatly. Now when she heard the evil words of the people against the governor, that they fainted for lack of water, and she said unto them, Hear me now, O ye governors of the inhabitants of Bethulia, for your words that ye have spoken before the people this day are not right. Nay, my brethren, provoke not the Lord our God to anger, for if he will not help us within these 5 days, he hath power to defend us when he will, even every day, or to destroy us before our enemies. Then Ozias said to her, All that thou hast thou spoken with a good heart, and there is none that may gainsay thy words. For this is not the first day wherein thy wisdom is manifested, but from the beginning of thy days all the people have known thy understanding. Pray thou for us, because thou art a godly woman, and the Lord will send us rain to fill our cisterns, and we shall faint no more. Then said Judith unto them, Hear me, and I will do a thing which shall go throughout all generations to the children of our nation. Ye shall stand this night in the gate, and I will go forth with my waiting woman, and within the days ye have promised to deliver the city to our enemies, the Lord will visit Israel by mine hand. But inquire not ye of mine act, for I will not declare it unto you till the things be finished that I do. Then said Ozias and the princes unto her, Go in peace, and the Lord God be before thee, to take vengeance on our enemies. Then Judith fell upon her face, and put ashes upon her head, and uncovered the sackcloth wherewith she was clothed. And about the time that the incense of that evening was offered in Jerusalem in the house of the Lord, Judith cried with a loud voice, and said, O God, O my God, hear me also a widow. Behold, the Assyrians are multiplied in their power. They are exalted with horse and man. They glory in the strength of their footmen. They trust in shield and spear and bow and sling, and know not that thou art the Lord that breakest the battles. The Lord is thy name. Behold their pride, and send thy wrath upon their heads. Give unto mine hand the power that I have conceived. Smite by the deceit of my lips the servant with the prince, and the prince with the servant. Break down their stateliness by the hand of a woman. Now after that she had ceased to cry unto the God of Israel, and had made an end of all these words, she arose where she had fallen down, and called her maid, and went down into the house, in the which she abode in the Sabbath days, and in her feast days. and pulled off the sackcloth which she had on, and put off the garments of her widowhood, and washed her body all over with water, and anointed herself with precious ointment, and braided the hair of her head, and put on her garments of gladness, wherewith she was clad during the life of Manasses her husband. And she took sandals upon her feet, and put about her her bracelets, and her chains, and her rings, and her earrings, and all her ornaments, and decked herself bravely to lure the eyes of all men that should see her. Then she gave her maid a bottle of wine and a cruse of oil, and filled a bag with parched corn and lumps of figs and with fine bread. So she folded all these things together and laid them upon her. Thus they went forth to the gate of the city of Bethulia and found standing there Ozias and the ancients of the city. And when they saw her, that her countenance was altered and her apparel was changed, they wondered at her beauty greatly and said unto her, the God of our fathers, give thee favor and accomplish thine enterprises to the glory of the children of Israel. And she said unto them, command the gates of the city to be opened unto me, that I may go forth to accomplish the things whereof ye have spoken with me. So they commanded the young men to open unto her, and Judith went out, she and her maid with her, and the men of the city looked after her until she was gone down the mountain, until she had passed the valley and could see her no more. Thus they went straight forth in the valley, and the first watch of the Assyrians met her and took her and asked her, of what people art thou, and whence comest thou, and whither goest thou? And she said, I am a woman of the Hebrews, and am fled from them, for they shall be given you to be consumed. And I am coming before Holofernes, the chief captain of your army, to declare words of truth. And I will show him a way whereby he shall go and win all the hill country without losing the body or life of any one of his men. Now when the men heard her words and beheld her countenance, they wondered greatly at her beauty and said unto her, thou hast saved thy life in that thou hast hastened to come down to the presence of our Lord. Now therefore come to his tent, and some of us shall conduct thee. Now Holofernes rested upon his bed under a canopy, which was woven of purple and gold and emeralds and precious stones. So they showed him of her, and he came out before his tent with silver lamps going before him. And when Judith was come before him with his servants, they all marveled at the beauty of her countenance, and she fell down upon her face and did reverence unto him, and his servants took her up. Then Holofernes said unto her, woman, be of good comfort, fear not in thine heart, for I never hurt any that was willing to serve Nebuchadnezzar, the king of all the earth. Then Judith said unto him, receive the words of thy servant, and suffer thine handmaid to speak in thy presence, and I will declare no lie to my lord this night. Our nation shall not be punished, neither can the sword prevail against them, except they sin against their God. And now, that my lord be not defeated and frustrated of his purpose, even death is now fallen upon them, and their sin hath overtaken them, wherewith they will provoke their God to anger, whensoever they shall do that which is not fit to be done, for their victuals fail them, and their water is scant, and they have determined to lay hands upon their cattle, and purpose to consume all those things that God hath forbidden them to eat by his laws, and are resolved to spend the first fruits of the corn, and the tenths of wine and oil which they had sanctified, and reserved for the priests that serve in Jerusalem before the face of our God, the which things it is not lawful for any of the people so much as to touch with their hands. For they have sent some to Jerusalem, because they also that dwell there have done the like, to bring them a license from the Senate. Now when they shall bring them word, they shall forthwith do it, and they shall be given thee to be destroyed the same day. Wherefore I, thine handmaid, knowing all this, am fled from their presence, and God hath sent me to work these things with thee, whereat all the earth shall be astonished, and whosoever shall hear it. For thy servant is religious, and serveth the God of heaven day and night. Now therefore, my lord, I will remain with thee. And I, thy servant, will go out by night into the valley, and I will pray unto God. And he will tell me when they have committed their sins, and I will come and show it unto thee. Then thou shalt go forth with all thine army, and there shall be none of them that shall resist thee. Then her words pleased Holofernes and all his servants, and they marveled at her wisdom, and said, There is not such a woman from one end of the earth to the other, both for beauty of face and wisdom of words. Likewise Holofernes said unto her, Surely if thou do as thou hast spoken, thy God shall be my God, and thou shalt dwell in the house of King Nebuchadnezzar, and shall be renowned through the whole earth. Then the servants of Holofernes brought her into the tent, and she slept till midnight. And she arose when it was toward the morning watch, and sent to Holofernes, saying, Let my lord now command that thine handmaid go forth unto prayer. Then Holofernes commanded his guard that they should not stay her. Thus she abode in the camp 3 days, and went out in the night into the valley of Bethulia, and washed herself in a fountain of water by the camp. And when she came out, she besought the Lord God of Israel to direct her way to the raising up of the children of her people. So she came in clean, and remained in the tent until she did eat her meat at evening. And in the fourth day, Holofernes made a feast to his own servants only, and called none of the officers to the banquet. Then said he to Bagoas the eunuch, who had charge over all that he had, Go now and persuade this Hebrew woman which is with thee, that she come unto us, and eat and drink with us. For lo, it will be a shame for our person if we shall let such a woman go, not having had her company. For if we draw her not unto us, she will laugh us to scorn. Then went Bagoas from the presence of Holofernes, and came to her, and he said, Let not this fair damsel fear to come to my lord, and to be honored in his presence, and drink wine, and be merry with us, and be made this day as one of the daughters of the Assyrians, which serve in the house of Nebuchadnezzar. Then said Judith unto him, Who am I now, that I should gainsay my lord? Surely whatsoever pleaseth him I will do speedily, and it shall be my joy unto the day of my death. So she arose, and decked herself with her apparel and all her woman's attire, and her maid went and laid soft skins on the ground for her, over against Holofernes. Now when Judith came in and sat down, Holofernes, his heart was ravished with her, and his mind was moved, and he desired greatly her company. For he waited a time to deceive her from the day that he had seen her. Then said Holofernes unto her, Drink now and be merry with us. So Judith said, I will drink now, my lord, because my life is magnified in me this day more than all the days since I was born. Then she took and ate and drank before him what her maid had prepared. And Holofernes took great delight in her, and drank much more wine than he had drunk at any time in one day since he was born. Now when the evening was come, his servants made haste to depart, and Bagoas shut his tent without, and dismissed the waiters from the presence of his lord, and they went to their beds. And Judith was left alone in the tent, and Holofernes lying upon his bed, for he was filled with wine. Now Judith had commanded her maid to stand without her bedchamber, and to wait for her coming forth, as she did daily. For she said she would go forth to her prayers, and she spoke to Bagoas according to the same purpose. So all went forth, and none was left in the bedchamber. Then Judith, standing by his bed, said in her heart, O Lord God of all power, look at this present upon the works of mine hands for the exaltation of Jerusalem. For now is the time to help thine inheritance and to execute mine enterprises to the destruction of the enemies which are risen against us. Then she came to the pillar of the bed, which was at Holofernes' head, and took down his falchion from thence, and approached to his bed, and took hold of the hair of his head, and said, Strengthen me, O Lord God of Israel, this day. And she smote twice upon his neck with all her might, and she took away his head from him, and tumbled his body down from the bed, and pulled down the canopy from the pillars. And anon after, she went forth, and gave Holofernes' head to her maid, and she put it in her bag of meat. So they twain went together according to their custom unto prayer. And when they passed the camp, they compassed the valley and went up the mountain of Bethulia and came to the gates thereof. Then said Judith afar off to the watchman at the gate, "Open, open now the gate. God, even our God, is with us to show his power yet in Jerusalem and his forces against the enemy, as he hath even done this day." Now when the men of her city heard her voice, they made haste to go down to the gate, and they called the elders of the city. And then they ran all together, both small and great, for it was strange unto them that she was come. So they opened the gate. Then she said to them with a loud voice, "Praise, praise God, praise God, I say, for he hath not taken away his mercy from the house of Israel, but hath destroyed our enemies by mine hand this night." So she took the head out of the bag and showed it, and said unto them, "Behold the head of Holofernes, the chief captain of the army of Azor, and behold the canopy wherein he did lie in his drunkenness. And the Lord hath smitten him by the hand of a woman. As the Lord liveth, who hath kept me in my way that I went, my countenance hath deceived him to his destruction, and yet he hath not committed sin with me to defile and shame me." Then all the people were wonderfully astonished and bowed themselves and worshipped God and said with one accord, "Blessed be thou, O our God, which hast this day brought to naught the enemies of thy people." Then said Ozias unto her, "O daughter, blessed art thou of the Most High God above all the women upon the earth. God turn these things to thee for a perpetual praise, to visit thee in good things, because thou hast not spared thy life for the affliction of our nation, but hast revenged our ruin, walking a straight way before our God." And all the people said, "So be it, so be it." Then Judith began to sing this thanksgiving in all Israel, and all the people sang after her this song of praise. "Begin unto my God with timbrels, sing unto my Lord with cymbals, tune unto him a new psalm, exalt him and call upon his name. For God breaketh the battles, for among the camps, in the midst of the people, he hath delivered me out of the hands of them that persecuted me. Azor came out of the mountains from the north. He came with 10,000 of his army, the multitude whereof stopped the torrents, and their horsemen have covered the hills. He bragged that he would burn up my borders and kill my young men with a sword and dash the sucking children against the ground and make my infants as a prey and my virgins as a spoil. But the Almighty Lord hath disappointed them by the hand of a woman, for she put off the garment of her widowhood for the exaltation of those that were oppressed in Israel and anointed her face with ointment and took a linen garment to deceive him. Her sandals ravished his eyes, and her beauty took his mind prisoner. Woe to the nations that rise up against my kindred. The Lord Almighty will take vengeance of them in the day of judgment, in putting fire and worms in their flesh, and they shall feel them and weep forever."